We want to find the volume of the solid with a height of y equals cosine x over the closed interval from 0 to pi over 2 with the width of 2 units. So our goal is to find the volume of this solid here. Before we do this, let's start with a review. We'll be using the volume by slices formula given here, where if S is a solid and A of x is the area of the face formed by a cut at x and perpendicular to the x-axis, then the volume V of the part of the solid S above the closed interval from A to B is equal to the definite integral of A of x integrated with respect to x from A to B. Let's explain why this works. If we were trying to find the volume of this solid here, the volume is equal to the sum of the volume of the slices of the solid. To estimate the volume of the slices, we could find the area of each face and then multiply by the thickness, which would be delta x. So the actual volume is approximately equal to the sum of the area of the face times the thickness. And as the number of these slices approaches infinity, this sum would approach the volume of the solid, giving us that the volume is equal to the definite integral of A of x integrated with respect to x from A to B. Remember, when we take the limit as n approaches infinity of this sum, it is equal to the definite integral. So going back to our example, to help us set up our volume formula here, we'll determine an approximate volume of a single slice, which will lead us to our definite integral. Let's begin by determining the approximate volume of this slice here by finding the area of the face and multiplying by the thickness, which would be delta x. We'll notice how this length here is 2 units, and this height here would be y, which is equal to cosine x. And therefore, the area of the face would be equal to 2 times cosine x. And then to get the volume, we multiply by the thickness, which would be delta x. And now we can use this to find the volume of the solid. The volume is going to be equal to the integral of 2 cosine x dx integrated from 0 to pi over 2. And now we'll find the antiderivative of 2 cosine x, which is equal to 2 sine x. And now we evaluate this at the upper and lower limits of integration. So we'd have 2 sine pi over 2 minus 2 sine 0. Notice how this would be 2 times sine pi over 2 is equal to 1 minus 2 times sine 0 is 0, giving us a value of 2. This would be the volume of this solid, and we're not given the units, but these would be cubic units. I hope you found this helpful.